anything stupid, and I'll throw you down the witching well myself.
All right.
You're making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep. How are you feeling? I know it's been a long night for you. You look like you could use some rest.
I'm feeling pretty fucking pissed off right now. If I'm honest, I'd like to smash everything in this room.
Is that a threat?
Depends on how much you like the furniture.
I didn't think that was funny, in case you were waiting for me to laugh. Look, I know what you must be going through. Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation. That's very helpful. Thank you. I'm Detective Brannigan.
Yeah, I know. I just said that. Is there something?
Do you hear that? Please. Please. I'm sorry. Just make it stop. Please.
We have to go, now!
What the fuck is going on?
You should be thanking me. It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive, but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours, and everything they saw at the Woodlands. Well, hurry up! certainly. We found Tweedledee chained up to a post. That was your doing, correct?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know why you detained him. Dee was at the trip trap when Snow was left at the Woodlands, so he couldn't possibly be involved in this mayhem. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him, and he hasn't said anything useful.
There's two of them, Dee and Dunn, and they've been snooping around every crime scene I've looked at.
That doesn't mean they're necessarily involved in the murders. I know what you're thinking, Bigby. It's been one full night and a slice of morning, and I already miss her too. You know, I never get more homesick than when one of us dies. And now, were it to be Snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening.
Yeah. It's hard.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused. Did she, give any indication to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was, I guess, fine, I suppose.
She just told me to be careful.
She was always fond of you, Bigby.
Yeah.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this. It's been two murders in as many days. If we don't unearth our culprit, and soon, there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby, for Miss White.
I got it.
That's not a very good answer, is it?
Come on. Just tell me what I want to know.
It will make things a lot less painful for you, in theory.
Oh, were you planning on using that? I just thought you really liked rubbing your little sword.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Hello, Ichabod. Sheriff.
Bluebeard.
I was just chatting with our new friend.
You were supposed to wait for us to get back. I told you, if you want to be involved, you will do things my way. No violence!
Whatever you say, Ichabod.
Hello, Bigby.
I want answers, Dee.
Oh, goody. I thought you wanted questions, and I was having so much trouble thinking of any good ones. Though I'd settled on, how's your head?
You see what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this, Bigby?
Do you think this is a joke? Snow White is dead.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
You were with me when it happened, dummy.
I still have questions for you, Dee.
Sounds like a personal problem.
This is ridiculous.
Let him work. He's got more experience with these kinds of things.
You know I saw you at Faith's apartment. What were you doing there?
Girl's got air conditioning. You can't imagine what it's like living in a little shithole with no air, especially with this heat wave going on.
All right, Dee. Let's get to know each other.
Fuck! So, this is how it's gonna be.
Just tell me what you were doing at Faith's apartment.
I can't tell you, and pushing me around isn't gonna change that. My brother and I work hard, and we keep our mouths shut. That's the deal.
I forgot about your brother. Dumb, right? How appropriate.
Where was your brother last night?
Are you accusing him of something?
What do you think?
He didn't do it, if that's what you're getting at. He didn't kill her! You have no fucking right to keep me here. You have no evidence. Give me my stuff and let me go.
What did you find on him?
Nothing of consequence, really.
I'm saving that.
This is really... What's the point of this?
Fuck! Stop, you fucker!
What are you doing?
Getting answers.
I told you to keep yourself under control.
Let me handle this. Where's your brother, Dee?
I don't know, okay? I haven't seen him since I left to go find Faith since we ran into you. But he didn't kill anybody, so you leave him alone.
You don't call the shots here, Dee.
You were looking for Faith.
For her fucking apartment! That's no secret, you saw me there.
No, there's more to it. You said you were trying to find something.
All right, Dee, since you never answered my first question, what did you want from Faith?
I'm not telling you shit. Got something to say?
I need to know what you were doing at Faith's apartment. You better start cooperating before I get mad.
Oh, I'm making you mad? Is that bothering you? You already burned me with the fucking cigar. Can't get any worse. You'll fucking pay for this!
What the hell, Bigby? I told you I didn't want violence, and what do you do? We could all lose our jobs! This is bad, Bigby. Look what you've done.
I'm doing what has to be done.
The only thing you have to do is what I tell you to do. Do I need to remind you that I am your boss? You answer to me.
What did you want from Faith?
I didn't want shit from that little thief. More trouble than she's worth.
I could say the same about you.
Oh yeah? Untie me and see how much trouble I am.
She stole from you?
She didn't steal anything from me, jackass. It was from my boss. You think I got anything worth stealing?
Your boss?
So let's talk about your boss then. Come on, Dee. It's clear you're just following orders. So who's calling the shots?
No! I'm fucking done. You mind loosening those? I can barely feel my fingers. You knocked my teeth out my fucking face, and now you want to be best friends. No fucking way! You're out of your mind!
You weren't answering my questions. As long as you're being helpful, there's no need for violence.
Unbelievable.
Why don't you just tell me who you're working for?
Look, you're not a bad guy, despite what Beauty says about you. At least, you're not a total bastard anyway. But I just can't give you that information.
There's no way Beauty would associate with a scumbag like you.
What's wrong with me? You're telling me I ain't pretty enough? Yeah, we're real close.
I thought this was supposed to be a murder investigation, but you're treating this guy like a fucking house guest,
Bluebeard!
You were making progress before. What is this patty cake shit? Snow White is dead. One of us. And you're going to let this ignorant shit walk out of here in one piece. Out of my way. I'll show you how it's done.
What the fuck?
What do you think you're doing?
Teaching him a lesson. Now pay attention.
Stop this right now!
You enjoying yourself?
Immensely.
Back off, Bluebeard.
Ah!
on, Duncan.
Snow.
What the hell was going on down there, Bigby? Abusing a prisoner like that.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay?
I hope it was worth your time.
Really scared us. If we'd just known you weren't actually dead...
I was working on this case. After a conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy. But hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer. Or at least to figure out who she is.
I should have been there, Snow.
I tried calling the business office, but there was no answer. I couldn't find you, or anyone, so I took care of it.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel responsible, in a way. She looked just like me. And maybe that's why she was killed.
Snow, it's not your fault.
But she looked just like me. That can't be a coincidence. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean, that's what it is, right? So, what's our next move?
We just keep doing what we've been doing. We do our jobs.
And I'm supposed to do what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems? Because that's what my job is right now!
That's not what I meant.
Well, then what did you mean? I told you, I'm tired of sitting around. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore!
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose.
I'm sorry. I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself. I've been doing it for centuries. TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too, you know.
Myself.
Right.
TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Bufkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Well, that's appropriate. And acids. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
Come on. I didn't realize... I've never seen her face before now.
Are you gonna be okay? You don't have to stay.
I want to stay. I'll be fine, it's just... a little... strange. The glamour is so effective, it's... invasive. But... just do what you need to do.
It looks just like Faith's did. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests. That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
If the neck wound was the same... there might be a ribbon in her mouth, too. Anything?
Nothing. So, it's not exactly the same.
Can you close her mouth? Thanks.
She got your perfume right.
How would she know? How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Rope marks.
She was tied up?
There were cinder blocks tied to her ankles.
Cinder blocks?
So she would sink.
Oh.
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah. Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms. Or if they're trying to hide the marks. Anyway, it means it's not a perfect match to your leg. Unless...
Don't be ridiculous.
Maybe she was trying to compensate with that perfume.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
It might be a cheap one, just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow, I need to open her coat.
Bigby, just let me.
Are you still okay?
Sorry, that took longer than expected. What have you found out?
Her glamour is defective.
Oh, defective?
We are thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yes.
We should keep going.
What is that?
She had the perfume with her. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. Do you see that?
Could be a bruise. Are you wearing silk lingerie, Snow?
Why do you want to know?
I'm just trying to see if the clothes are exact.
They're not. I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic, though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous. Don't you think?
You may be right. One way to find out.
Huh. What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
Might want to stand back if you're worried, Crane. I'm gonna try to open it. Something to do with these rings here.
Deer. What does that mean? Oh. Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think... This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Let me guess. It's my hair.
Yeah.
Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
All right, you can calm down. It's not like you haven't seen a troll before.
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
She looks like Holly.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly, it's her sister Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows, she might know something about this, who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
Do you want to talk to GJ first?
Yeah, I do.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
We'll fill you in later.
Good.